that's what I got for number 8.
Hold on. I found a mistake, I feel like, in one of your problems. It's 25 times 2. You think it's 60, right?
Yeah,
I got a 50. I got 50.
No, because, like, 5. Oh, yeah.
Mistakes. You always need them. I think. I don't know.
Okay, thank you.
Peer coaching is a strategy that and a structure that helps students work together with parameters of roles and holds both students accountable for their learning and their coaching. The students partner up together. One of them becomes partner A and one becomes partner B. So in the first round, A will look at the problem, will discuss with their partner and tell them how they think they will solve it. And then partner B will look at partner A and say, okay, I see what you've done here, and either they'll agree and they'll write down the answer, or they'll say, well, we may want to think about doing this a little differently. And they'll coach them through how to do it.
First we do the exponents, so that's 10. You agree? Okay. Oh wait, no. 20.
5 times 5 you have to do.
Yes, I get it.
Yeah.
I get it, because this one is supposed to be 5 as well?
Yeah.
Okay.
So you're times it by 2. So if it was 3, it'd be 5 times 25. 5 times 5.
So it's 25. So then multiply 25 times 2 and do that on the side. That equals 50.
Mm-hmm. I agree.
Plus 4 equals 54.
I agree. Great job on that one.
Thank you.
It works better having each of them accountable for one problem and also accountable of coaching the other person, because then they both have buy-in to what the answer is. And I found in the past that if you just have them work with a partner, one person takes over and then the other one just kind of follows along. One of the advantages of peer coaching is, as a teacher with 34 students, I have often gone around, you know, circulate around the room, and I go to one student, they had a question, then I turn around and another one had a question. By that time, the same student over here has the same question again. So now I've got half of the class coaching half of the class. And the students seem to really like it, because they like to listen to each other, sometimes more even than a teacher in front of the whole class.
Okay, so 14 subtracted by 3 is 11.
Good.
Times the 9 times 11 is 99.
Okay, that's good.
99 divided by 3 is 33. And the answer is 33.
Good. It is 33.
Yeah, it is 33.
Good job.
So if they've already asked their partner and they're stuck at that point, they have a signal as when, instead of raising their hand, they put their hands together and put them up in the air. Then I see, okay, they've already asked each other, so now they need me, and I'll get over to them.
16 times 2.
Wait, wouldn't it be 6 times 2? Because it's between that?
Yeah, but we still have to do something with the exponent.
We could just leave that there and wait for the end of the problem.
Do you want to ask Ms. Flanagan? Because I think we should.
Let's ask her.
Yay. High five.
I think the growth that I'm seeing using this strategy is because they actually have these roles that they're assigned to, and they have to stick to the structure. So it holds both of them, again, accountable for it.
Okay, now for number 6, we have parentheses, so it would be 6 minus 3.
Yeah, we do 6.
Which is 3. And then after we look for exponents, there are exponents. So first we do the exponent, so 10 times 10 equals 20. Wait.
10 times 10.
No, wouldn't that
be 100? The power of 10s.
Yeah, wouldn't that be 100?
Yeah.
Thank you.